அனைவரின் சார்பாக ஐயாவை வருக வருக என்று வணக்கத்தை தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறேன். வணக்கம் ஐயா.
ஐயா வணக்கம், அனைவருக்கும் வணக்கம்.
ஐயா இன்னைக்கு சஞ்சய் ஸ்ரீவாஸ்தவா, ஹி ஹஸ் கம் ஆன் லைன் ஃபர்ஸ்ட். ஐ திங்க் ஹி ஹஸ் கம் ஃப்ரம் பிகனீர். ஓகே, இஸ் த ஹாட்டஸ்ட் பிளேஸ் மேபி நவ். ஐ எம் அன்மியூட்டிங் சஞ்சய், யூ கேன் டாக் டு ஐயா.
Namaste, Aya.
Vanakkam, Aya, vanakkam.
So I have a question. Like, I understand that in our psychological state, we don't have to interfere to alter the psychological state. But when there is some unhappiness or sorrow, then there is a natural desire to interfere into it. And the teaching says that you should not interfere. So there is another conflict created by the teaching itself. Because there is a natural desire to interfere, to remove the sorrow or unhappiness, and the teaching says that you don't interfere. So that conflict is there. A new conflict gets created. So how do I resolve that?
Are you able to follow Tamil, or do you want to speak in English?
I cannot follow Tamil.
We cannot follow Tamil. So here, in some moment, we may have sorrow or fear within ourselves as a psychological expression. But the expression may be related to the situation. The situation may be the reason for our sorrow, for our fear. Here, what is left here is to deal with the situation. But unfortunately, we try to separate ourselves psychologically. We want to be free from sorrow. We want to be free from fear. In this way, we have some anxiety to separate ourselves psychologically. Here comes our understanding. So our understanding, what our understanding says is that we have to give total freedom to the psychological expression. Or it may be natural. We have to take it as the natural one. Natural sequence, natural phenomena, whoever will be in the position, the same reaction will be there. So we have to accept wholeheartedly our emotions. It may be fear, it may be anger, it may be sorrow. We should not find fault with our emotions. We have to accept them, all them, as wholeheartedly, as a natural one. So this is our idea, this is our suggestion, how to deal with our psychological factors. But physically, we have to do what is needed according to the situation. So physical work is different, and the psychological aspect towards which we have to follow, we have to meet the psychological features, is different. So psychologically, we have to accept what is happening wholeheartedly. We should not find fault with anything. We take everything as natural, and we have to accept them wholeheartedly as a natural happening. So that is a way of approaching the problem.
I understand that. We have to take it naturally, and we have to accept it. Hmm. But the non-acceptance is also a natural response. I mean, I understand that I should accept it, but there is a feeling of non-acceptance. That also comes as naturally.
So the non-acceptance happens because if you think we have to be free from the bad emotions, we want to be, that is the natural response will be like this. Because we do not like the unnecessary happenings. We want to be free from the unnecessary because it creates some suffering. So naturally, we want to be free from those kind of sufferings. It is a natural response. But at the same time, we have to understand. We have to understand that this response is not correct. If you respond like this, the problem will continue forever. So what we have to do to come away from the problem once for all, that we have to accept wholeheartedly. So our understanding says like this. If you give weight to the understanding will operate naturally and automatically.
And how to accept it wholeheartedly?
So we have to make it fair, logically or psychologically. We have to give consent to the weight to the understanding, give weight to the concept of accepting everything as it is. So we have to give weight through your mind, through your knowledge, through your intellect. You have to appreciate the rightness and correctness of our understanding. Then only your appreciation will make it act on its own.
Yeah, I understand it intellectually what you say, but the thing is that I try to give weight to this acceptance, and it's still that denial, that feeling of denial comes. And then there is another conflict, that why should I have this feeling of denial? So this is a kind of vicious circle. It continues like that.
So you have to inquire and find out. So your finding alone will make you release. Otherwise, if you do not come to a conclusion, if you do not come to a right conclusion that you need not fight with ourselves, then the fight will go on. So you have to come to a conclusion. You have to come to a right conclusion that it is meaningless to fight with ourselves. So you may fight with the circumstances, fight with the physical things, but you should not fight with yourself. Fighting with ourselves is meaningless. So you have to understand the meaningless of our psychological fight. So if you understand intellectually or anything, then naturally the understanding will make you operate on that way. So here our understanding must be correct.
Okay, namaste. Yeah, thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you, Sanjay ji. We look forward to you for future occasions.